Good morning, gamers and chat. Gauntlet Gamer here. Today is Saturday, May 7th. It will be continuing more of Lost Odyssey. So let's begin.
Yeah! some peace in me!
Sorry,
bro.
That wasn't very fun.
Nice.
Thank you.
did it!
Yikes!
see.
Whew. Yeah, this is much better. Time to relax.
You all right?
Yeah, somehow. Mac! You okay?
I'm so tired, Cook.
Why have you come? Oh, you're all...
You don't remember me? I'm Seth. Seth Balmore. This is Kai Marganar. We're comrades. Remember?
Comrades? What do you mean by that?
Here, let me help you.
Majesty, I'm terribly sorry for the trouble. It will be over. Just a moment.
Sorry, this will be over in a second.
Hey, Squeaky! Don't care about the Queen's continued good health, huh?
Huh? Ming!
You!
Get out of the way! You do anything funny and the Queen gets it! Figurehead or not, she's still the Queen, Tiny. If anything happens to her, you'll be held responsible. You know better than to try anything, right? I mean, you're not stupid!
You're a real thug! You know that, Jansen? There's an exit in the back.
Huh?
Behind us.
Jansen! Keep it up! And fall back!
Right! Don't move! Don't move! Don't you dare move! Get it? Don't move from that spot!
You swine!
Dang. Just going back and forth, what the fudge?
Thank you.
otherwise of no use? Huh? Why aren't we moving? Go! Move! Forward!
Here goes!
Ooh.
Thank you.
Why would you slam your hand on the metal tank?
Wait.
Yeah, sorry about that thing back there.
Don't be.
Well, I didn't want to pull a stunt like that, but listen, did I hurt you? I'm sorry if I did. I didn't mean it.
It's fine. Everyone is safe now, after all.
Well, you know, I should really be thanking you for helping us escape.
Well, since these children were there. You're acting kind of weird. You got a crash.
Shut up. We had a moment there.
Ming, are you okay?
Yes. Cook? Mac? Why are you two... Did something happen to your mother?
She's passed on.
Please don't let your spirits fall. I'll always be with you.
Thank you, Aunt Ming.
Oh, why would a big boy like you be crying, Mac?
He's going to change from here on out.
Seth.
Hmm?
What you said earlier, that we were friends, is it true?
Yeah, but this isn't the best place to stop and talk about it. We need to get out of town.
What will you do, Your Highness? You said earlier you couldn't leave because you were the Queen.
I'll go with you. It seems I must.
You come with us?
Yes.
Awesome. All right.
Hold on! We're being pursued by both Numara and Gungara. We should probably find a ride.
Ride? Where? How?
Let's go to the harbor. I've got an idea.
Harbor? What the fudge? View composite magic tutorial. Yes. Some magic spell can be combined together to form us. What is known as all composite. To cast a composite magic, you must be able to use both spell that compose it. Okay. Use the spellbook under main menu to check the spell required for composite magic. Any composite magic for which you lack the required spell will not be dispelled. You only use composite magic spell for which you have the required skill level. Okay. Yeah. Ooh, this is gonna be hard, but name is pretty good too. Oh, I can't. Shit, how do I guess I have to sacrifice Cook for now. Spellbook. All flare, all shadow, all wind, all ground. No, all heal. Okay. Yeah, no, we have Zephyr. That's heal. But... Peace. The seal grants you make the seal. Good boss magic. She probably needs level 3 magic. Yeah, I think that would be much better for me.
What's up?
Hey, how's it going?
Eh?
Hey, that engine. Where'd you get it?
Oh, this. Let's see, when was that? A while back, an unbelievably huge fish washed up on shore. This was in its belly.
We checked it out and realized it could deliver incredible output, so we fixed it and installed it in the boat.
Did the repairs work?
Like a charm! That boat was built to be General Kakanis' command vessel. Installing it is all that's left to do.
I see. Thanks.
Don't mention it.
A huge fish, huh? You know, a while back...
Is there something you remember?
I really depended on it.
Depend on what? The fish or the engine?
The engine... It's from back when I was a pirate. Huh? Seth, you were a pirate? Yep, that's right.
Wow! Amazing! That is so cool!
Huh?
Oh yeah, I've always loved women who are pirates and swordswomen and stuff. I read books about them for like, ever! It is so exciting to meet a real woman pirate. To make a long story short,
she wants to be your apprentice.
Yeah. What he said. Could I? So, Seth, Mistress Seth, please let me be your apprentice.
Thank you.
Inform General Kakanis that the engine installation is complete. He said to call him when we're ready for a test run.
Oh, hey, look! Someone's aboard!
Oh, hey!
Hey yourself, you little...
What are you doing there? Get off! Go! Get word to General Kakanis! Hurry!
Yes, sir!
Your ship is leaving. Thank you. All right. Should be easy. Ooh. Wow. A lot of buttons there. Gotta need a manual, I think. I'm
out of the way, Emma.
Damn.
Well, here goes. Starting engine.
With the sandals at hand, you are able to traverse to the wide open ocean. Hold the left stick in any direction to the slack nose in motion. Hold the right stick in any direction to set the camera view. Some areas are as shallow ice field. And hypercurrents are not negatable even to the sand as stonos. Press the RB to move stonos bridge to return to sea latitude approach cockpit. Control confirms that we want to fly. To approach the shore, press A, land here on the button. I press A to exit the sand. To make the world map appear, click the right stick and move the closest map point. To reboard some style nodes, choose the landing point on the world map menu and press the A button. I suppose it's not that, that's my question. I guess we go inside the ship and know what to do.
Wow! Look at all
Are you feeling
buttons,
okay?
Don't.
Yes,
yes.
I'm fine.
I'm the only one that's without you.
Okay then, where do we start?
Have your memories come back?
Nope, it comes in fragments. Same as you, bits and pieces.
Please tell me what you meant by saying we were comrades.
Do you have dreams?
Yes, I do. What about them?
Have you ever wondered if those dreams might be fragments of your past? That there might be something turning round and round in your heart, different from the way you are now? Have you ever had a rush of feelings?
Wow, you're like saying more than one word since you began your memory back.
Yeah.
Well, you're still as fun to be with, though.
Well? Have you experienced anything like what Kaim is talking about?
I'm not sure.
You know that you're called the Thousand-Year-Old Queen, right? And your body is supposed to be immortal?
Yes, but I don't know why I'm called that. Or why my body doesn't age. I don't understand anything.
That must be why Kakanis looks down on you. You've lost your purpose.
It's just that... How should I put it? I often feel as though there's something terribly important that I'm forgetting. And it pains me. As though it may not be in my memories after all. But my heart remembers the pain. There have been many times recently when this has happened. My body wouldn't move, like it was exhausted. And then I would collapse. When I felt this vague sense of unease coming on, I would often play the harp, and that would calm my mind.
So that's what you were doing when we met?
Yes. Kakonis frequently advised me to lift the country from its isolation. At those times, he recommended nothing more than expanding our information about the outside world. But it seems that his true objective was something else.
No. This is what they call fate. See, meeting me was predestined. That means Kakonis just played a role. He was a pawn to make it happen.
All right, that's enough, buddy.
Okay!
All right, Seth!
Ming, I felt the same as you until recently. My memories were locked up.
Your memories were locked up?
You, me, Seth, and Sarah. And one more whose name that you as queen should know. The Uren sorcerer, Gungora.
Yes, I'm aware that there is a sorcerer called Gungora, but...
The five of us were once comrades. We had a 1,000-year agreement. We came to this world to accomplish something important. For that reason, we were made immortal. We don't age. When the end of the 1,000-year agreement drew near, Gungora betrayed us. Though we couldn't die, he inflicted pain on us that was worse than death.
Pain? What kind of...
He deprived me of someone more important to me than myself. He cruelly stole her from me, and inflicted a deep wound on my heart that can never be healed.
I also had something important stolen from me. Gungora used magic energy to block my memories and seal them within me. After he wiped out our entire lives, we became like living corpses.
Then I too have had something very important stolen, and my memories locked away?
Yes.
What could possibly be so
important? Don't push yourself. Take all the time you need to remember. Oh yeah, I have something to return to you.
Return? To me?
This really saved me.
I met you before, didn't I?
Yeah, 200 years ago. I borrowed this from you back then.
I must meet with Gungora.
That's what we plan to do.
He's up to something that involves Grand Staff. We have to stop him. That has become our mission.
Guess that means our destination is Ura, right?
Hold on. If we go to Ura, we'll have to cross the ocean. In a boat like this, there's no way we'd make it.
Even with your engine, Seth?
It's an old clunker.
Oh, it's got power to burn. But the ship itself wouldn't be able to handle the strain. It would fall apart.
Why don't we head for Gotza? They've made the most progress with magic technology. I am the Queen of Numata. I shall request aid from the King of Gotza in the name of our countries and for the world's future.
Gotza, I gotta go to Gotza. Oh, I see that market there. Let's go inside the ship interior, see if there's any stuff there.
Land at last!
Dry land! No more worrying about sinking on that stupid ship.
Hey, what the hell was that for?
The slant nose will never sink. Not with the captain's engine on board.
You think you're so cool now that you're a pirate? Well, I'm gonna teach you a thing or two about the pirate code.
And what code would that be?
What code? Well, that would be a secret pirate code that we would do if
touch
we had the time.
Touch my head!
Hey, Grandpa! Wow, you have... Cook is such a... And what a kick! Boy, she's strong, that cook.
Wow.
I have no idea what you've just said.
Well, what I'm saying is that cook is as cute as a button. She's just... Oh, you must be proud.
You lying creep. Cook, it hurts when you get kicked, you know? But he insulted the captain. Isn't that right, Captain? Captain?
Tremendous.
Sad.
Did a sad stream. Oh, wonder beast. And Miria, proud descendant of the White Wing Clan, you alone were my increased best. Irresponsible companion. Would it anger you to call me as two of a kind? Thank you. stomp my knee in fear and trembling, while others voice it with deepest admiration. Some even call me the righteous buccaneer, nor were not far wrong, I say. The pirate ship I command have rules that work near and strict. We target only the kind of vessel, those of blend, passenger ship, the wealthy onboard for pleasure cruise. We would put a bit of a scare into the passengers, of course, or maybe rock them a little, but killing was strictly forbidden. All we did was squeeze a few drops of treasure out of the curse for those who had made more money than they knew what to do with. We traded our booty for cash, we shabby leaders, and the money shared in the wilderness for property. I would flinch at being called a champion of justice, but we pride ourselves. As I keep mentioning, I can never age or die. try and kill me, and they knew it. The most they could do is be rocking me a little and threaten to make it worse for me next time. They had to do something to show them that I'm popular. They couldn't just let me mourn in the pirate's game and pretend it never happened. So I said, we were in a cave in the desert. I was in handcuffs, nighttime, surrounded half a dozen fishermen. All the entire captain's body was loaded, a long thick chain. I get sick to my stomach just thinking I could be ready for something that beat me here with a chain. No matter strap, whatever you choose, there you have to get rid of my love. Hey, and get on with it, said the leader. Too bad for you, said this is punishment. It's not the kind that can be heard of. Just sorry we can't stay with you again. Yeah, playing another man. I'm not a monster like you. You have stole a lot of time. Okay, man, let's make it fast. The lady of monsters. Making his name the man in the chain. They chained me to a gigantic boulder in the cave, and they were laughing so hard that they hardly could take this out. Just what I need, they said, is the end of the rope for you. We can't shoot you, or we can't stun you to it, so we will just knock you out. We'll never come back to the time again, and even have a big fire that you know suspicious. On sea lanes, no fishing boats here. And right now your men's have been off looking for a long island. We're the only ones who knows we brought you here. Not even our crew knows where we are. Nobody's come to save you, that's for sure. You'll be here forever. Can't move a muscle, can't even die. All by yourself, all of us are dead. With that, the men walked out of the cave, leaving me to this single life. Cowards as people, don't run off like that, don't do this to me. But the only response was the whole pile of everything that was the cave. The lantern, the man left behind us, not me as parents, but my real opposite. He was a proud and a very young driver of people. As long as the lamp just keep glowing, I was filled with rage for the man. But when the oil was running low and the flame began to flicker, a deep excitement exalted me. Unable to move, I stared blankly at the flame. Eternity. This world has no such day. Was my destiny. I would be surrounded by companions whose feeling matched my own perfectly. I couldn't share the deepest love with another, but in the end, I would always have to lose them. Do you know what it feels like to see I'm friendless? Others scum to death while you yourself on the border in the sky. In that case, we do have something here. As I watched the man in the kingdom, a wall of darkness spread before me, and I was alone, but no more would have tasted so hardly apart. But neither would not ever be disappointed without any remorse. by shouting to people's shout. You speak for a reason. Because they want someone to hear them. Because they believe there's someone who will hear them. If all there was nothing to do was to stay by myself, struggling against eternal solitude, incapable even or rather knowing that it was the purpose of my living in the world, perhaps the man who brought me here had been right, unable either to age or not, perhaps I was some kind of monster. Then why was such monsters living in this world? What was I supposed to do here? I did not know the answer for that. I will never know the answer to the end of myself. To the end of my never-ending life, I felt frustration, sorrow, all about all fear. Eternity was frightening to me. Solitude was frightening to me. I might be trembling, but without even the energy of my big utter dream. Whatever it was I was feeling, it was that it was it happening. That is you first of all to me. This is a long story, guys. Hope you a tiny light burst. A tiny burst of light softened the darkness, and the light almost before I could wonder what it was. There came a voice. Are you too trapped in a prison of solitude? Who is that? In the light of a flash, white wings, then a sudden increase of size and brightness. The light searched my eyes, accompted to the dark, total darkness. My eyes could not stand the glare, and an instant they could not see anything at all. I clapped my eyes shut before starting to open them little by little. There before me hovered a pure white glowing beast. It was a white wing, brightly taking beautifully. How beautiful you are, Arneria, but yours was not a florid beauty. It was stubbornly different. Your beauty wore a cloak of loneliness. I am like you, he said. I am cloak my head at you. Look at you, the puzzlement, you continue. I have been looking for something like you for a long time, very long time. You spoke softly, majestically, all immortal love. You and I share a single destiny. You and me, whoever is together, let us escape this solitude and make our way together. Who said your eye locked around me? Escape this solitude, the world continue bringing up my ears, but I do not know who you were. I do not tell even, I cannot even be sure about where you are. conversation of one could not tell as a friend or foe. Who are you? As I am Aneria of the White Wing Clan. White Wing Clan. I heard that many before the White Wing Clan were said to be a wondrous beast that became extinct in the distant lands. I heard that the White Wing Clan died here long ago. I am the last of the bloodline, the only survivor. Indeed, as I said, the last, which is why you speak of solitude. At this point, almost before I knew it, a weak, almost self-mocking smile creeped over my face. I felt myself overlaying my guard as I spoke to you. My chains, however, were digging even deeper into my flesh and shackling my heart as well. You used the phrase prison of solitude before. It's true, this is a prison. Being alone for eternity is a prison of ours. You nodded at this word of mine and here, yeah, in silence, but then you said I was in prison too, until just now. I'm sure it's true, but the only thing living survivor, I have spent far too long. In the legend, members of the White Clan are taught to live 1,000 years, but even you live on several centuries. A sole survivor could never meet a female member of the clan of the White Clan and hope to make their child with her. The clan will never rise again. The sole survivor must live out there with the name of his great alone. She said, I will need someone to make her way with me. Then you looked hard at me and said, oh, pirate woman, are you not of the same mind? I nodded in agreement. But then I made a funny smile and said, casually as I could, in other words, you're lonely. Your beautiful face talked then and I said, sorry about that, guys. The hell. Virgin. Where are we? Your beautiful face softened and you sit with some embarrassment. I wonder, according to legend, as I heard it, the clan of the White Wing are proud and love their solitude. The only increase your embarrassment, and you said solitude has its limits. That it did. I decided to crush you then and there. Well, if this is how you feel, you should come right up and say, I want company. Company? Alright, a companion, exactly. So it's decided. At the end of the hesitation, just as you saw in me, wanted to make your way together with you, I put my full trust in you. Those while on the sea I brought you. Isn't that what makes our way together? Chain that held me down. inseparable partners, friends, family. Jeez, that's one long story for Seth.
Some things from a long time ago.
You mean when you were a pirate?
And remembering made you cry? I've always been a pirate. I was crying because of something that happened that I regret.
Changed a bit.
Oh shit, this is one of the issues. Can't win. You're not gonna remember. I'll be right back, guys. I gotta use the bathroom. Power and because I think somewhere way up on all the people. This being the magic part, how do you get to the people to look for treasures hidden all over the world? The five treasures in my life, the king of the solution, the very powerful and the treasure. Once you get the creation of the treasure, you will appear from the treasure sitting in the king that I am. And you will have magic power to create a creator, which there will be a growing part of the application that you have ready to reach the treasure sitting. The treasure sitting at the growing point, just for it at the end of the year. It's the optimal match of the application, but anyway, you find more treasure than the level of the indicator. Keep the chat. We all meet outside neighbors, but really, I don't need to stay here for an hour or something to see you.
I'll go speak with the king. We've never met, but I've heard he's very wise. I'm confident that he has a ship that can get us past the hypercurrents.
Wow, that hit the spot. You know, I'm finally starting to feel at home. No.
Are you even listening to me?
No.
There's a time and place for that stuff, and this is neither. Tell me, is it really true you can't drink?
Yes.
That is so sad. But you're a queen. I mean, don't you have wine or champagne at parties or banquets, hangings, any festive thing like that?
No.
Well, look it. Nobody knows us here. Come on, just give it a try. I guarantee you'll like it. Really. It won't kill you, I promise. In fact, I bet if you take a couple drinks, you might get your memory back. Yeah, it relaxes the mind and other things.
You think so?
Absolutely. Hey, look at me. You're talking to Jansen here. Bottoms up.
Bottoms up.
What? You don't like the cheap stuff?
No. It's just I've never tasted anything like it before.
You don't have to force yourself to drink it.
No. I want my memory back. If there's any chance this will help, I'll manage to drink it.
Wow, that good. Are you okay?
Ooh, I feel very lightheaded all of a sudden.
Hey.
It's affecting me like you said it would. Oh, your muscles are so...
Yeah, she got drunk fast.
Oh.
Dang.
Oh, no. You know, you're cute when you're asleep.
Jansen!
Ah! What? Oh!
What the hell do you think you're doing?
We're having a serious discussion about, you know, what's gonna happen next and planning.
Happen next?
Yeah. You know, she's gonna talk to the king and get us a ship, because yours can't float where the... You know, after all, Goats has got the most advanced technology around. We figured we'd get a more seaworthy ship from him. So that, you know... What?
All right, I'll give you the benefit of the doubt this time. But don't try any funny business with Ming.
Damn.
Yeah, well, I'm looking out for her too, you know. I mean, look how restful she looks right now.
Restful, she's strong.
Hey, Kai! I heard you were back.
This place takes me back. And it looks like the years have been good to you.
Knock it off. I'm a bona fide old man now.
Well, if you don't mind my saying so, you've aged really well.
Thanks, honey. Drink up. This is on the house.
Well, that is mighty nice. I don't mind if I do. Can I have that big, large mug over there?
I was only 7 when you saved the village. But I remember you as if it were yesterday. You were a hero to us kids back then.
Yeah? So, we're trying to get to Goatsun.
Forget it. The only way is through the Black Cave.
I heard it'd been closed off by some old sorceress.
There's nothing to be afraid of. We'll just bust our way through.
It's not that simple. Neither muscle nor magic have had any effect. Although adventurers with plenty of both have tried. My guess is that only that old sorceress can bust through the blockage. She's got some serious magic energy. Yep, she sure does.
Why don't we wait until she goes to the bathroom? Then we can sneak by her.
It gets better. You know that place where you and Sarah lived? Well, that old sorceress has moved in.
My house?
What? You don't even have a lease agreement?
We kept the place up after you and Sarah went away, so it'd be ready if you ever came back. But I'm afraid she's made a mess of it. Sorry.
Don't trouble yourself. It saves us the hassle of having to look for her.
That's a good point.
The only thing to do with squatters is run them out.
Well, I think you'll be okay. Just be careful, Kine.
We're off to kick some old woman's butt!
That doesn't sound right.
You're not gonna go off and leave Ming like this, are you?
We'll head out there tomorrow morning.
Jeez, I'm tired already. Well, gamers and chat, that will be. I'll be ending my stream today. I'll see you guys maybe tomorrow. We'll see what happens. Till then, this is Gauntlet Gamer signing out.